Today, we're going to take a look at how DocToHelp takes your existing Word documents and transforms them into whatever outputs you need. One of the things DocToHelp does is that it automatically breaks Word documents down into individual topics and organizes those topics into a table of contents. This is based on heading styles. Most Word documents are already set up this way. Let's start by taking a look at our IT policies document on setting an out-of-office reply. You can see in the navigation pane that heading 1 is at the top of the hierarchy, and all the heading 2s are underneath the heading 1. If you wanted to create another topic and slot it beneath the heading 2, you'd apply a heading 3 style. Once I have a project set up, see the video on starting a new project for steps on how to do that. I can add my document to my project and start taking advantage of everything DocToHelp can do for me, and my Word document. I just need to click the Add Document button in the Documents pane. Browse to the document that I want to add and add it to my project. You can see that the document and its content have been added, not converted. That's an important distinction. This file is still a .doc extension. It hasn't been converted to a proprietary format, and if I double-click it, it opens in Word like any other document. When you open it, the DocToHelp toolbar gets added on to any document in your project. You can use the toolbar to enhance the content in your project, customizing it, and adding interactivity to meet your needs. We have a number of videos on just the toolbar that you can check out, so I'm going to close this document and go back to DocToHelp. You can see that the contents pane is empty, and so is the topics window. That's because I've just added the document, and DocToHelp hasn't scanned through it yet to create an output, topics, and TOC. I'll go to the Home tab and build NetHelp, our web-based output. When it builds, DocToHelp creates the topics, organizes them into a table of contents, creates the interface for the output, and catalogs everything for search. When the build finishes, you can see the topics have been created and the table of contents matches what we saw in the navigation pane in Word. When I view the NetHelp, I can see that the table of contents is the same there. And all the content from the documents, including the screenshots, is in there. We understand that all projects and documents are living projects and documents. They change over time. If you want to add or subtract content over time, you follow the same process of adding a document and building your outputs. Let's say our company adopts Google Mail as their mail service, which has a different way to set up an out-of-office reminder. But we would still want to keep the Outlook instructions during the transition. We'd add a document just like we did before. And build. This time, we'll build a manual output instead of NetHelp. It will all build as one output with one table of contents. Since the new document is slotted under the original document, the new content appears underneath the original content, with its section of the table of contents structured according to the heading styles in the document. When the build finishes, the topics list and table of contents updates. And the table of contents is updated and added to the PDF. When I built the PDF, DocToHelp added the content section, but it also added a cover page and an index because it knew I would want those items in a printed manual. I was able to create two different outputs with two different interfaces using the content that I already had. I was able to do this without fundamentally changing or really even touching the content. That's what DocToHelp does with your Word documents. To learn more and download a free trial, go to DocToHelp.com. I'm Brad Keller. Thanks for watching, and thanks for choosing DocToHelp.